In the previous videos in this series, we already created a Java application running on a Raspberry Pi to send sensor data to HiveMQ Cloud, the online MQTT compatible message broker, which is free to use for up to 100 devices. We also created a Java FX dashboard to visualize all the values we received via HiveMQ Cloud. Now a final step with the newest board in the Raspberry Pi family, which was launched in January 2021, the Pico. This isn't a full Linux PC as the Pi 4 and 0 we have seen before. No, this Pico is a microcontroller, so you should compare it with an Arduino for instance. You can program the Pico with C++ and MicroPython SDKs. The Pico provides a lot of GPIOs at a very low price of only $4. Because of this low price, there is no wireless on board, which is a problem if you want to send messages to an MQTT broker. The microcontroller used on the Pico, called the RP2040, is also used already on other boards, of which some include Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. But for this example, I combined the Pico with an Adafruit Airlift. Adafruit creates and sells a lot of electronic components, and on top of that, they provide a lot of documentation. Also on this breadboard is a distance sensor, and this is the value we will send from the Pico to HiveMQ Cloud. To be able to do this, you will need to copy several libraries to the Pico, which is very easy as it is connected as an USB drive. We need to add two more Python files to our Pico, one with the credentials of both the Wi-Fi and HiveMQ connection, and another one with the actual program we want to execute. To make this program easy to understand, there's a lot of commands and logging added. When adding this code with the MU editor, we can see the output in the same program, which makes it very easy to debug. As you can see in the terminal window, the distance measurement is sent every second. Now let's add this value from the Pico to our JavaFX dashboard of the previous video. We just need to add an extra tile and link it to the topic used by the Pico to see this extra value in the tile with the name Distance Pico. Again, the article with the full description of this project and a link to the source code is included in the description of this video. As you can see, sending and subscribing messages via HiveMQ Cloud is a great way to exchange data to different types of computers or microcontrollers. As the data is just text, it can be generated or used by any programming language, and you can use the language of your choice on each platform. I like to invite you to start experimenting with either the sources of these three posts or with the many other examples you can find on the HiveMQ website. Have fun, and please share your creations.